Everyone, it is Marie here from Skeins. And yes, I know I have been a little bit vacant for the last couple of weeks, not been around, but I am back and oh, I've got so much to show you. I'm so excited. So much to show you. It has been an absolute manic couple of weeks here at the mill. I've been running. I'm so excited. We've got a lot going on, particularly too with Mid August Nights coming up, which of course is less than a month away, which is really, really exciting. And Mid August Nights, for those that don't know, is a yarn event held here in Napier. 10 years this year, we bring loads of people out. It's really, really exciting. And with that, we also try to bring new yarns, some really incredible specials. There's a lot going on. So we've been doing a lot of preparation for that. But one of the things, and I'm going to kick off with it because I'm this excited, that I've been hanging out to bring you, and I've been talking about it over the last month or so, has been the launch of our new yarn, Legacy. Now, Legacy is the Heritage Organic Merino, which is a yarn that many of you adored. It was a yarn that we absolutely loved. And it was done in a soft two-fold twist. And the upside of that yarn is it was beautiful and it was lovely and it was gorgeously soft. The downside of that yarn is that in that soft two-fold twist, it meant that it gave you this beautiful lush bloomed fabric, but its wearability could definitely, if you're particularly in adult garments, it does require a lot of care and maintenance, lots of depilling, and you just really do need to look after it. I personally am actually a real big fan of yarns with a little bit higher amount of twist. So what we did was, is when we cleared Legacy out, we have created Legacy Heritage Organic Merino out, we've created this new Legacy yarn. So what we did with Legacy is we have created a yarn that there are two elements with it. One is it is the full farm to yarn traceability. So the fibre, we've actually bought this fibre direct from the grower. Most of the fibre that we get in, we've bought in from another third party, so whether it be a wool buyer, a broker, or large wool clearinghouse. In this particular case, we have gone and bought all this yarn, all this fibre, direct from the farm itself. So the fibre we have in here is the same organic merino that we used to have in our heritage, which we absolutely loved, which now comes from Eden Valley in West and Dumbleyung. Isn't that a wonderful name? Dumbleyung, Western Australia. And there is also, so 70% of this is organic merino. 30% of this is premium Polworth, which is from Mātakanui Station, which is in central Otago. And Mātakanui are probably the best known Polworth producer here in New Zealand. And we have now gone and created with that this incredible yarn. So I know the first question off your lips is why the Polworth with the organic merino? A couple of reasons for that. One is Polworth as a fibre, so the Polworth in here is also very fine micron. It is, Polworth is a, our spinners love it. It is a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful yarn, and it's a really wonderful yarn to spin. And what it does is it just helps smooth everything out. It just really helps everything hold everything together. And the Polworth we get from Mātakanui has got this really fantastic long staple on it. It is, which is the length, really good long length. And the neat thing about that is it just helps hold everything together. So what we've gone and done is we've gone and created this wonderful four ply yarn. And actually I'll do it on this one because that's probably an easier one for me to get out. Yep, there we go. And what we've gone and done is, what you probably can't see it there, but we've gone and created a higher angle of twist on this yarn, which gives you a really nice cylindrical piece of yarn. It gives you fantastic stitch definition. It makes sure that your If you're doing a smooth fabric like stocking stitch, it is all beautiful and smooth. But if you're doing textured stitching, it's nice and crisp. Textured stitching, your lace is well defined if you're doing lace. But the best thing is because there's a higher angle of twist, it keeps the merino fibers, which are just that little bit more flyaway than the pole width, it just helps hold them together in the yarn. So the wearability on it is a lot better, which was one of the criticisms we had with the previous. So I think it gives you the best of both worlds. It gives you a really good stitch definition, it gives you a wonderful looking fabric, and it hopefully should wear very well. This is not a machine washable yarn. This is not a shrink treated yarn. This is not a machine wash treated yarn at all. Because of the organic merino and because of the ethically farmed Mātakanui Polworth, we wanted to do as little mucking around with this as we possibly could, because we don't believe we need to. This yarn is so beautiful and the fibres are so precious that really, this has had the minimal amount of impact from us. This has been fibre, prepared, spun, coloured, and then dyed. There's been no extra jiggery-pokery, nothing. It is really quite a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful yarn. So it is perfect for any project that you might consider, from infants all the way through to adult garments. It's got a huge ability to cover a whole multitude of bases, and it is just utterly stunning. I want to go like this, but I've got pink lipstick on and I'll probably put pink everywhere. But this is it. I'm going to try and hold all of them up. There's 11 colours, and we've tried to do a mixture of really lovely brights along with some softer, more muted shades. And here they are here. Oh, look at that. There's the last one. Look, right, so there we go. So those are all the colours there, plus this cream. Now, if you have been doing the floozy cardigans, this stuff will be perfect for floozy cardigans. I'll just move that so you can see them. Now, the other really nice story about this, I mean, obviously we've called this Legacy because of the legacy of where the fibres come from. The fact, as I mentioned before, this is a farm-to-yarn story. The names of all of these yarns have all been given lovely names. So this one is Isla. This is Cooper. This one is Bethany. It should be Bethany. Bethany. Joseph. Chloe. So as you can see, there's a theme. There's all these beautiful names. All of these yarns have been named after either the children or the grandchildren of our team here at Skeins. There is no Louis and Hugo in here, which are my two, because those two have been immortalised before in yarn. But we have Claire's children here, we've got Virginia's children here, we've got Karen from on our team, her granddaughter is mentioned here. We've got the grandchildren of Peter and Mary Tatton. We have two of the boys from the Jackson. So these yarns, it's also not only the legacy of the fibre that's gone onto the yarn, but the legacy of the families that make it as well, which is all of our extended Skeins family. So Legacy is now live. It's got its own category. If you jump onto the site now, it is there. It is completely live. $8.95 a ball. So that's fantastic value for premium merino. And it is 4-ply, a 174 meters per ball, so great mileage on that. And it's a recommended 3.25 to 3.75 millimeter needle. The swatching that I've done on this, I actually find a 3.5 is just, for me, a 3.5 is fantastic. There are a lot of patterns actually lurking around with that 26 stitch tension, which is often around that sport weight, that will actually fit into that 24 to 26 tension quite beautifully. So do check it out. It really is a wonderful, wonderful yarn. So I'm so excited about Legacy. Now, if you've also entered over on the Skeins Speakeasy, the Guilty Pleasures competition or the Guilty Pleasures postings, Legacy prize packs is what you're going to be getting. So I'm absolutely delighted that it has literally just come in today, because that has all come in nice and ready for that prize draw, which is going to happen on Thursday. So if you haven't yet posted up your Guilty Pleasure over on the Skeins Speakeasy, make sure you do so, because you could go into the draw to win a prize pack from that beautiful, beautiful Legacy yarn. Exciting. What else has been happening since I have been sort of on my mini hiatus? Opal, a number of you was asking about Opal, and we haven't had Opal for a while. Ta-da, it's back. Just went up this at the end of last, I think Friday we put this up. We had a big clearance, a bit of a clean out with Opal. Was it during the epic sale? Not that long ago. And we sort of, we've been waiting for a new, Opal do these wonderful collections. And the last sort of few collections hadn't really spoken to us, but this new collection we totally, totally love. It's called Butterfly. And it is just really wonderful and whimsical. And the colours, as you can see, these are some of the brights, these beautiful bright colours. They all come through as the classic patterning that Opal is actually famous for. So that beautiful striping and ferruling. There's also a couple of more neutral shades there. All in all, we've got 8 shades in total, and we've got all of them. So those are all online now. So if you're after your Opal fix, do definitely jump on and check out that new Butterfly collection. We have those there all ready for you. Also to the new Outlaw colours. You may have seen some of the posts that Debs has been popping up over on her Outlaw pages, and I know she's done a lot of photography this weekend. I have, hopefully I'm going to get all of these up before the end of today. If I don't, they'll definitely be up by Thursday. But we've got the new Worsted colours. Look at those. See, this is, I don't know what it looks like on your screen. It shows very dull here, but this is like the most intense, vibrant green. This is the Kelmscott, which is in already in the Sport. She's popped it over into the Worsted. But she's got these really wonderful colours that are all a little bit richer and more broody. They almost sort of have kind of a tapestry sort of feel about them, and they really are quite delicious. I mean, look at that. Absolutely beautiful. So I'm just, these are some of the new Worsteds, because of course we've been clearing out those discontinued colours. One of the colours, as many of you know, that I'm was a touch crabby about was the amber type, which was one of my absolute all-time favourites, which is that guy there. This is the new one, which is pretty much the tonal version. So this is this one is called Larkspur. So this is basically amber type on steroids. So it's the same shade, but a richer hue. So she's been forgiven for me because it's one of my favourite colours in all of her range. So yeah, there's some really, really lovely colours. I'm just going to pull out my magical bag of tricks here, because in here I have the new Sport colours, which I haven't even seen yet. It's like Christmas for me too, really. Ooh, there's very nice pink in here. We all know I'm partial to a touch of pink. So we've got, yum, like that. So that one there is called Baroque. Isn't that lovely? And that's a beautiful, rich, burnished gold. Again, these cameras, what I see and what you see are two quite different things. But look at those. Oh, that's lovely. That's actually showing blue on here. It is actually quite a jady green. So those are some nice, rich colours there. And here these are some sort of lovely broodier shades. So I'm really excited about those. I'm hoping to have them all loaded up. If I don't get them to them today, they'll definitely be up by the end of the week. So that is Outlaw. What's going on with Outlaw? In terms of my projects, I've been on, not a go slow, I've been working on another project which I didn't bring in, and I can't actually show you because it's about to be a gift and it's nearly done. But I have also at the same time been working on my Arfi sweater, which I'm planning to have this done for mid-August night. So I'm nearly there. I'm literally, as you can see, onto the band at the bottom down there. But now, see, doesn't that fabric look fantastic? I am so happy with this. I am the drape of the fabric is brilliant. It feels great. I'm kind of hoping that maybe by the weekend I'll have this close to finished. And once I do, I'll let you know what all the modifications were on that pattern, so you know what's going on. Afi is online now, and this is, as I said before, it's just got that really wonderful texture that's up there in stocking stitch. So if you're looking for something to give you a little bit more interest into your knitting, I think Afi is definitely a yarn that you need to check out. Last but not least, the biggest thing to have a look at is having a good look at what's on special and what you're up to and what you're doing. And we haven't really had much of a special in the last little bit. So I've been on the phone this morning to my favourite importer and distributor about looking at what yarns that we could have moving forward for the spring, because there's always interesting things that crop up with him come springtime. And I also wanted to do a bit of spring cleaning so I could make space for more stuff to come in. And he has agreed, bless his heart. Well, it was a slight a bit of arm twisting from me, of course, but you know, that's I'm looking after you, really. So, Merino. Classic Prince Merino, and so those are just an example of what I'm talking about. We've had this at the lowest at $4.95 as part of the Sweet Charity pack specials at $49.50. I've spoken to him this morning and I've said to him, look, we've still got oodles of this. I want to be able to really special it out. And he said, okay, yes. So, are you sitting down? I hope you're all sitting down. Right, put your cup of tea down, put your coffee down, because if it's hot, I don't want you to drop it and it can't burn, because I don't want to be responsible for that. You put everything down? No, put it down. Put it down. I'm not joking. Put it down. Right, good. Okay. This normally retails at around $11.40 a ball. Yes. Well, if you happen to go to the yarn clearance page right now, you will see that there is about 11 or 12 of these sitting of both four ply and double knitting, sitting on there for $2.95 a ball. No, that is not a typo, people. $2.95 a ball. Yes, that's right. See, that's why I made you sit down. I didn't want you to drop anything. $2.95 a ball, 100% machine washable merino for all of these prints. And essentially, it's going to stay at that price now until they're cleared. Once they've gone, they're gone. These are discontinued colours. So if you're knitting for charity, if you've got babies that are due September, October, and there are always a lot of them rolling around, you need to make sure that you jump on and stock up on these, because now at that price, I'm picking they're going to fly out the door faster than someone, you know, us at a shoe sale, to be honest. We need to get those gone. So $2.95, make sure you jump in there and snap those up before they all disappear. Very exciting, I know. So it's a bit of pre-can love before can, because you all always know that I do loads of love for can. I'm working on that at the moment. Don't you worry. But in the meantime, just to whet your appetite a little bit, with can still only still 3.5 weeks away, make sure you jump on to the clearance page and snap those up. And that's pretty much all my news for the moment. I haven't done any research on any patterns or anything for you yet. And I've been talking to Claire about a theme for next month. We're not 100. Well, we're percolating at the moment, percolating what we're going to do there. But I will have all of that for you on Thursday. So don't you worry about that. So just remember, Thursday we're going to be drawing those Legacy Prize packs as part of the Skeins Speakeasy Guilty Pleasures month, so do make sure you get your posts up for that. Last but not least, Cannes. For those that can't make it to Cannes, and many of you can't, what you may not be aware of is Stephen B, who is our headlinist, Stephen Berg from Minnesota in the USA. He is actually then going on a nationwide tour after he's been with us here in Hawke's Bay. So if you're in Central Otago, you'll be able to catch him in both Dunedin and Arrowtown. He's also then going to be teaching in Christchurch, heading up to Wellington, and then jumping out. And I think he's doing a class or two in Auckland as well. I will be getting all that information and popping that out. I'll be sending it out to everyone on the Skeins group, and as well as everyone over on the August Nights group. So if you aren't able to make it down to Cannes, but you want a little bit of Cannes to come to you, you'll be able to do that. And then once he's been with us here in New Zealand, he's popping over the ditch and he'll be doing some stuff, I think, also in Australia and Sydney and Melbourne as well. So it's a chance for you to get a little bit of can at your place, which will be absolutely brilliant. But until then, have a great rest of week wherever you are. The kids are all back at school. Yeah, I'm excited about that too. It's the little things for me this week, I tell you. But look, in the meantime, don't forget about this. $2.95. It's all got to go. I want it gone. All of it. But until then, I'll see you on Thursday. Bye.